One, two, three, four.
Thank you for joining us this week. This week we're using some objects, fairly ordinary objects, just to help us think about faith. We've had a dumbbell, didn't we, on Monday, just helped us think about exercising our thankfulness muscle. How are you getting on? Are you doing the exercise program? And then yesterday we had Lego. We thought about that, how creative Lego is, but also how Peter describes Jesus as our cornerstone. We're to build our lives on him. The creative possibilities of building good lives, of playing well, that Danish word of Lego meaning to play well. We're called to play well in our lives, so we point to Jesus. Well, today, I'm going to think about the humble lemon. Now, if I squeeze this lemon, what would come out? I'm going to try that now. Hopefully this will work. Hopefully you can see that. If you squeeze a lemon, what will come out? Well, of course, lemon juice should come out. We'd be amazed, wouldn't we, if anything else came out. And smell the lemon too. The question I want to ask today is what happens when we are squeezed? And by that I mean, you know, what happens when we're facing pressures, when things build up, when things annoy us, when frustrations come, when life doesn't work out how we want it to. We're squeezed. What comes out of us? If a lemon juice comes out of a lemon when it's squeezed, what comes out of us? What comes out of our mouth? What comes out in our attitudes, in our behaviours in that moment? Well, we're going to come back to that thought in a minute, but we're going to read something from Matthew's Gospel, Matthew 5, connected around the Beatitudes. Those early teachings of Jesus that we know as the Sermon on the Mount. I think it will connect in with our lemon today. So we're going to read from Matthew 5, 3 to 16. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. And blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when people insult you and persecute you and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt loses its saltiness, how could it be made salty again? It is no longer good for anything, except to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. So we sort of have three images today. That image of the squeezed lemon, the image that Jesus gives us of being people who are salty and people who are light. And I guess underneath those three images, there's that same challenge. What difference are we making? How is our faith worked out in our lives? What happens in times of trouble and stress? Who are we deep inside? How do the people around us see our faith? When they look at us, is it a beautiful aspect, attractive aspect of our life? Or is it pretty non-existent? Jesus says we're meant to be salt, but have we lost our saltiness? By that I mean, have we lost that distinct nature of being a follower of Jesus that should mean we're different in some ways to those around us, and should mean that we are like Jesus in what we do and what we say? Salt in the time of Jesus was used for a variety of reasons and purposes. Just some of them I'm going to explain now. It was used as an antiseptic, had healing properties, also used as an anti-inflammatory, reduced swelling. It was used as a preservative to keep food fresh. It was used to clean. It was also used, I didn't know this, to help human waste decompose. But it was used as a flavour in cooking to bring out the flavour. So the question for us is, how are our lives as followers of Jesus reflective of those things? How are we like an antiseptic bringing healing? Anti-inflammatory, how are we at bringing peace and reducing the heat of conflict around us? How are we at preserving what's good? How are we at cleaning up and making our environment better than it was before? How are we at bringing out the flavour of good flavour of God in the world around us? And it's often in moments of stress and pressure and struggle when we're being squeezed, like I squeezed that lemon, that who we are really, truly comes out. If you or I are squeezed, does our faith and our love of Jesus pour out of us? I came across a really challenging question in one of the books I was reading recently. It says, what would look different about your day, my day, to anyone else if I was not a Christian? And I guess what that writer was saying is, you know, if today I wasn't a Christian and I lived my life, would it make any difference? Would it be any different? If you took that part of me away, would it make any difference in how I responded, how I acted, how I dealt with life? That's a challenging question. Would people notice if that part of my life disappeared? And that's our challenge today. If you're squeezed, what comes out? Are you being salty in the world around us, bringing flavour and healing and peace? And of course, that other one we've not looked at, that light, you know, it's the light of Christ shining through us, not just in the good days, but in the days when we face struggles. That's when people watch us the most, isn't it? That's when people notice if our faith is truly making a difference. I'm going to pray for us. Father God, creator of an amazing universe, we approach you with grateful hearts for all that you've given us. We submit who we are to you, and we give you the praise and the honour and the glory. We were created in your image, fearfully and wonderfully made, but made for a purpose, made to be salt and light in this dark world. Guide us in the paths of right living, according to your will and your glory. Shape us, form us into the likeness of Jesus. Help us to behave and live like him, making a difference in the world for your sake, for your glory. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. May God bless us as we go out into the world today.